Now it's time for Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul.
Welcome to a live program, everybody.
Whoa.
Which is bad because I record it and then I'm going to play it another time and it won't be a live program.
But right now it's live.
That's okay. A little disappointed because we thought Boogie would be here, but he's not here
today. Yeah, what's up, suckers?
Yeah, it's a great question. It's a question for the ages. Looks like he had maybe a family thing going on.
Oh, man. Well, it's a bummer. I was looking forward to seeing him.
I considered him my family until this moment.
Well, he's definitely part of the Past Week, Next Week family.
Yeah, and I did have the texter on the line, but he's gone now. Oh. So I don't know what's going on.
So it's just you and me.
I don't know if we can do this, because here's the thing, everyone. The thing that's happened the last couple of weeks is that we've been spending a lot of time together, and it's like, Oh, God.
Again?
Gotta hear this guy's stories. But that's okay, because we do start the show with a song that symbolizes the last few weeks. Chris?
Yeah.
Did you see the prep? Oh, there. Here's the text.
Oh, excellent. Okay. Well, we got somebody back here. I did take a look at the prep. Yeah.
Okay. So I'm doing a different song.
Oh, you are? Yeah. Okay.
Okay. But here is Smokey Robinson with Cruisin'.
Oh, okay.
On Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul starring Boogie and introducing the texter.
We would love to hear that.
It's from 1980. I thought it was, this performance is from 1980. Taking it. So I think I've figured it out, by the way, but I don't want to give up the gig too early. You were a huge fan of Eddie and the Cruisers, right?
Yep. And?
And you probably watched it.
And yeah, pretty good, but you're kind of missing something.
Dude, we just got back from a cruise.
Yes, that's correct. But also, Tom Cruise was at the Taylor Swift show last night.
Oh, okay, that too. Yeah.
So, we were on a cruise for a long time.
Yeah.
It may have been too long.
You think so?
It may have been too long.
It was a long trip. I will say I'm still recovering, I believe.
I'm exhausted.
Yeah, me too.
Traveling and seeing the world and seeing the beauty of the world is so wonderful, especially with loved ones.
Oh, man. Yeah.
But planes, trains, and automobiles, oh, my God.
Yeah, the flight over for us was 7 hours, but the flight back was 10 hours.
Why was that, you think?
I don't know. Maybe going into headwinds that way. Something to do with the jet stream.
Would you fly out of?
So we flew out of Chicago, and then we flew back into Chicago.
Same place, okay.
Yeah, same place.
So we flew from Atlanta. And flew to Boston. And Boston is international, and you could get a connecting flight, but they are not set up for any type of connecting thing. Their international terminal is way far away.
Oh, wow.
We had an elderly man that wasn't me, even older than me, that was with us.
What?
And Boston was a mess.
Oh, wow. Wait, so you went to Atlanta and Boston?
No, on the way out.
Oh, on the way out,
Kansas
you went
to Atlanta.
Gotcha.
Atlanta to Rome, and then on the way, Rome to Boston.
Yeah, gotcha.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we had to probably fly a couple hours further than you to get to Chicago as opposed to flying into a Boston. Man, look at Smokey's. I don't remember seeing Smokey with a mustache ever.
He's so effing cool. Look at him.
Oh, he's so cool. Yeah.
Now, a lot of times, maybe just because I'm exhausted.
Sure.
When you see someone that talented, you think, well, there has to be a God, because that is so...
Yeah.
That gift. But I was looking at this earlier, and I'm like, there's no God. He couldn't give me just, like, the coolness in Smokey's pinky, just so I could have some.
Yeah.
No. Just give it all to Smokey.
It seems mean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's cruel. Look at him.
Yeah, Smokey's awesome, man. Gosh, well it was a trip for the ages. I'll say that.
Oh, Gilly.
Oh boy. Oh, Gilly.
Okay. Oh, we have special in studio guest Gilly.
Hang on, I gotta get her.
Is she all tangled up? She's trying to get in Boogie's seat.
She's trying to be our buddy.
Yeah. Yeah, she's our buddy, but not our boogie.
Yeah.
And I want everyone to know that. So it's fun to be back. I'm really glad the texter showed up online. What I'm hoping for is that we can get Brian through Zoom because he went on a trip. I'd love to hear about that.
Yeah, there's been lots of European adventures of late for the past week, next week crew.
Yeah. I'd love to hear more about that. But
okay,
if we can get Brian. But yeah. Okay. So, yeah. You ready to start the show, I guess?
I guess. Let's do this.
That's Smokey Robinson with Cruisin'.
Mm-hmm.
On Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul.
I'm Chris.
Starring Boogie, introducing the texter.
I'm Chris.
And I'm Paul.
What's up,
suckers? And this is the show where you review the most important things for the past week and get you ready for the next week. Get your One Stop Podcast. Keep you updated. It's a real week review. Just listen to us. You won't need any other information outlet. That's our guarantee. Thanks for listening to us online at kctkradio.com or Facebook Live at KCTK Radio page. When we were gone, we had a podcast through our regular podcast means, and then one special on Facebook Live.
That's so fun.
It's funny how you would use the word special. But it's easier to use the KCTK Radio smartphone app. If you don't have it right now, download it. It's free. And join the experiment by calling or texting us at 913-735-0060. We welcome your participation. Coming up, we have your weekly news quiz. We don't have a pop culture update.
Okay.
We have an incredible special feature. We talk about Europe,
ooh,
headlines and predictions, and much, much more. We're going to spend a lot of time on the next segment, the first segment of the show, and it is called What's Going On?
Yeah.
A little more Motown.
Yeah,
for you.
How about that?
Let's... You mentioned in our pre-show prep, in our meeting, up in the offices.
Sure.
Boogie has been busy.
Yeah.
And I'm looking forward to hearing all the details of it, but could you just, I mean, you're on Twitter, X.
I am. One of my newest follows is a guy named JoJo, and mm-hmm. Boogie knows him extremely well.
Okay.
And I'm following, and apparently all JoJo does is get offers to go play football at like 10, 12, 15 colleges.
Well, and choose gum, but he's out of strawberry gum.
Yes. Yeah. So I'm excited to hear what is happening with JoJo.
Do you
and
feel
football.
Well, it's been an excrement, so you can say what are some of the offers he's gotten.
I mean, I've seen Pitt State. I've seen Northwest Missouri State. I've seen UNI, which I think is the University of Northern Iowa. North Dakota State, I believe. Augustana. I think I saw Washburn in there.
Okay.
Like, just every college around here you can think of. It's pretty impressive.
Yeah, so he's been very busy with that.
Yeah. Yeah, and good for him. And, you know, it's got to be good for him to have, like, talented kids and just at least be able to see what having talent is like.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I'm happy for him.
Yeah, it's we have a similar situation where we have absolutely no talent, but we have talented kids.
Yeah. I don't know how that works.
Yeah.
It's weird.
It's weird that he has a talented kid.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, blows my mind.
Yeah, it's weird.
But there you go.
So that's the latest from Boogie.
Yeah, waiting. Whoa, really excited to hear the details on all of that.
And I'm wondering if we could get Brian, I know he's listening, if we could get him on the Zoom and...
Whoa.
And where we could listen to him because he's a... You know, sometimes featuring Brian is a big part of our show.
Right, yeah.
Brian, can you hear us? Are you there?
I can hear you.
I'm glad you're on because we want to hear about your European adventure before we dive into ours because yours happened first.
Yeah. I'll tell you about the night before.
Okay.
I was in a tornado.
Oh, yes. Yeah, tell us about that. Yeah. Dude, that's a scary situation.
Yeah, didn't know it was a tornado when it happened, but it was.
And you live in Kansas.
Truck totaled,
right?
Car totaled.
Oh, man.
Roof totaled.
And you live in Kansas, where I guess it happens.
We have them
every other day, or I forget. Very
couple
frequently.
Times a day.
Okay.
Oh wow, twice a day. That seems excessive. Yeah. So was your truck completely totaled?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
How about your bicycle? Were you able to still drive that around?
Marge's car was totaled.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Oh. You guys have not had great luck with cars in your...
You just bird poops on your car now and they total it.
Mm. Wow. So do you have a new truck yet?
I have a new truck now.
Yeah. Congratulations. Yeah, what kind of truck did you get?
Thanks. I got the same kind.
Oh, good. No, that's a good kind.
It is, yeah. It's a big one. Yeah.
It's a big one. You know that.
I was happy.
Okay, so I'm interested in this. What was it like that you had a tornado and I got to leave for Europe for a couple weeks now? I couldn't even imagine the stress.
Yeah. We planned on that day being just calm and let's pack and hang out. And it was chainsaws and roofers and tree guys and generator and blah, blah, blah.
Poor dumb bastard. Gosh.
Yeah.
But then once we left, Ed, I didn't care.
Good.
Didn't think about it. I didn't, nothing.
Nice.
So. You went to the Soviet bloc.
Yeah.
Where Putin is in charge, I believe. Yugoslavia is where you went?
Yugoslavia.
Mm-hmm. That's where you went, right?
We did not go to Sarajevo.
Okay.
Yeah.
But you went to Croatia. It's called Croatia now.
Yes. Yeah. We went to Zagreb first and spent a couple of days there. And then went up to the... which used to be Italy for hundreds of years.
Oh, yeah, don't you forget it.
East Istria. And then went down the coast and did kind of the tourist stuff down there, Dubrovnik and Split.
So what did you do most of the time? Was this a relaxing hanging out on the beach, or was this seeing every sight you could see?
A little villa in the middle of nowhere where we just hung out and did nothing.
Nice.
It was cool. It was a little compound. There was a bunch of sheep that came by one day, hundreds of sheep.
Wow.
I was walking out to the car and they were all in the fence and they all just hopped over the fence and left. But then hundreds went by.
Were you happy to see that?
Yeah, that was kind of fun. I don't see that in Kansas
here. We were hoping to see that in Sicily, but we never did.
Yeah. Saw sheep from a distance, but I have heard that Croatia is just gorgeous. Did you find it to be stunningly beautiful?
Everywhere you went, you were like, let's take pictures. Let's take pictures. Every single place.
Yep.
Now, did you take any pictures?
So Jane and I were together on a lot of the things, and Jane did take a lot of pictures. We've got some gorgeous pics to look at, for sure.
What is that nice thing you're holding up, Brian?
We bought this painting from Voltaire in Porridge, and then he invited us into his house, and we had drinks with him. And
with Voltaire?
A couple came by that knew him. say that again.
Voltaire.
Voltaire, yeah, it's like awesome. Walter with a V.
Oh, okay. Got you. So not like the famous Voltaire that I'm thinking of but can't place. This was just a regular
guy named Voltaire.
Voltaire Dodich.
Oh, okay.
Oh, he's
that guy. Yeah. Yeah. Well, the picture was lovely.
Yeah, he's a good artist, and it was super fun.
Oh, wow.
And he spoke broken Croatian-Italian hybrid.
Yeah. What was communicating tough over there?
No. I went to the tourist center in Zagreb, where everybody speaks English, but I wanted to flex a little bit. So I said, "Govorite li ingleske," which means, "Do you speak English?"
Oh.
And she said, "Govorite li hrvatski," "Do you speak Croatian?"
But you did know the word for no, right?
Nay is nay, no, nay. Da.
There you go.
Yeah, I know some of the words.
What's bathroom in Croatian?
They'd say.
Ah, yes.
So, we went to mostly Italy. We went to Greece and Turkey, too, but I learned banyo. for the bathroom.
Yeah.
It was toilet.
Yeah, everywhere it was toilet.
Yeah.
That's in Spain or in Mexico, baño.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it was very Mexican.
And Spain, I'm assuming.
I would assume, but I don't know.
I don't think you should have that type of racial judgment on people. They may not go to the bathroom. We don't know their culture.
As white people, we do.
Oh, see?
Okay.
Sitting in your white
privilege. Look at me. You're
privilege.
Right. You're right. I don't know if they go to the bathroom.
Right. Now, you were on a trip with five of you? Is that right, Brian?
Six.
Four
of the kids and two of the parents.
Oh, I always forget about one of those kids.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
And they know which one I'm talking about. And how'd that go? I mean, that's a lot of people to... Did you guys separate at all? Did you do different things? Or
Mornings, we just said, you do what you want to do. You don't have to wait for anybody. Just get up and go. If you want to take somebody with you, you can. So and then we'd kind of rendezvous at, I don't know, 10 o'clock. And then I'm going here, I'm going there. Mm-hmm. We ended up always doing stuff together, pretty much.
That's nice.
How was the food?
Food was amazing. Amazing.
So what's some typical Croat dishes?
Well, it's different on the coast than in Zagreb, inland. Inland, it's kind of a more of a meat and potatoes type thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I had some goulash in Zagreb that was not like goulash with the noodles that you think here. It had rice in it, but it was probably the best food I've ever had.
Oh, wow. Dang.
Wow, that's
on the coast.
You've had chicken before too, fried chicken.
I've had chicken too.
Yeah, in your own home,
it's delicious.
Then we had octopus.
Oh,
it was really good. I was a little bit nervous to eat it, but it was really, really good.
Was it chewy?
No.
Okay. Wow.
No.
Must have been prepared nicely.
Yeah, that was a 12-course meal that turned into a 15-course meal.
Egads, man.
Wow.
They just kept bringing stuff out. It was so good. Like the best meal, fanciest meal I've ever had.
Dang.
Well, you deserved it. You went through a tornado.
Yeah, we told everybody that too.
And they're like, really. What is this tornado?
I'm sure you did.
Yeah. Well, some people would say, where are you from? We say Kansas because they know Kansas from
tornadoes. Yeah.
Sure. Yeah.
And then we said, some of the people we actually told them, we were actually in a tornado the night before we left. What?
Did you tell them your house landed on a witch?
And squashed it.
Yes. You got to carry the gag. You just got to go with it.
Yeah, driving there. So here's one thing that I really like about driving in Croatia is the stoplights go from green to yellow to red. But then on the opposite side, they go from red to yellow to green.
Oh.
Everybody starts going at yellow. And when it's green, you're going through the intersection. There's no that here, everybody, it's green. Oh, let me get, okay, now I'm ready to go.
Yeah, yeah.
You're going.
That's nice. Go. Yeah, we could do that here.
Yeah, we could.
Mm-hmm.
And what to...
You don't run the yellow light, though.
I'm curious on this. How was the flights and everything? Good?
Flights were good. We rode a little prop plane from Belgium to Zagreb.
Oh, wow.
Kind of funny. It wasn't little, but it was a prop plane. It was two rows of, two seats and two sides of the plane.
Man. How long was the main flight? Like
8 hours, I think.
Okay. Yeah.
DC to Brussels was like 7 hours, 55 minutes or something like that.
Gotcha. Gotcha. Yeah.
So KC to DC, DC to Brussels, Brussels to
Zagreb.
You haven't seen my phone, have you?
No.
I haven't either.
And then Dubrovnik to... Then we flew out of Dubrovnik and flew back to Frankfurt.
Wow.
Then to DC.
Did you have any challenge? Did you or anyone in your group have any challenge with packing?
Yeah, Joe did.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Too much, too little.
Yeah, just not enough time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We just...
What about you? Did you procrastinate or did you just pack?
No, I had time, but I just like, then I would weigh my bag and it's like too much. So I had to get rid of stuff. And then I had enough stuff.
We only took check bags. But carry-ons.
Oh my gosh. Wow.
Wow.
Wow. Yeah, we didn't do that.
Did you wash your clothes in the mill?
Yeah.
Okay.
See. Yeah.
Yeah, every place we stayed had a laundry.
That's nice. That, yeah.
So, and did you drink a lot?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, good.
And
wine, a fantastic bottle of wine is $6.
Wow.
Oh my gosh.
That's like a $30 to $40 bottle here.
Wow.
$6. Don't even bother buying the $10 bottle because it's just as good as the six. Just.
And then you're pocketing $4.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're losing money if you don't get that.
Yeah. Wow. That's brilliant.
And you're losing a lot of drunken time if you don't.
Yeah.
So how long?
$1.35.
How long did it take you to adjust back to not have jet lag?
Going there was nothing. I didn't have any. Coming back was about 3 or 4 days.
Yeah.
Plus, all right, that's where I am.
Depression. I was depressed.
Coming back home?
Because you had to be on the podcast? Oh, wait, that was me.
Still wanted to be there.
Yeah.
You guys have that?
I'm living it right now. You're looking at it, pal.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's something going from...
Nobody knows what you went through. Everybody is, unaware of what you've been through, and you want everybody to experience what you've experienced.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But luckily, we have a podcast to tell everyone what we did.
Yes.
Well, I'm glad you had time of your life, didn't you?
Yeah, truly.
Will you go back, do you think?
In September of 2025.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Look at you go. That's awesome.
Yeah. Jen's like, we're going back in September next year.
That's awesome.
That's great. Man, happy for you guys.
Yeah.
Sheesh.
Wow.
It was so much fun.
Now, Chris.
The whole family will go this time.
Now, Chris, you also went to Europe.
I did. Yeah. First time in my life. Yeah. So flew out and flew into Rome. And Jane and I flew in a day earlier than everyone else in our crew. So
who was in your crew? People have been asking me that.
So there was me and Jane.
Okay, that's your lovely wife, Jane. Right?
Yes. Yeah. Jane, my wife. Mm-hmm. There was the Hogue family. So we had Reggie and Nunzia and Stella and Annie. And for those, playing along at home, Nunzia is Nancy's cousin.
Yes. First cousin. Yeah.
And then you and Nancy went as well. Yes. So we had a
crew of eight.
And I
am Nancy's husband.
Right. Yeah. And she is your wife.
Yes.
So we were all going on this cruise together. Jane and I ended up flying in a day early. So we had a day in Rome where we just ran hither and yon and saw everything we could see from the
I was absolutely Trevi amazed fountain. By your story.
Oh, it was nonstop. Nonstop.
I was amazed by your story and so thankful that I wasn't with you.
Yeah. I would not trade that day for anything, but it was a hard day. Very hard. It was so hot. And we ran. Jane had been on the Instagrams and the Pinterestes and knew the things that she wanted to see. So we saw the Trevi Fountain, the Pantheon, the Spanish Steps, the Colosseum. Trying to remember what else, but we just ran all over. And it was so amazing to be in the midst of all of that history. It was just, it was humbling. It was surreal.
Rome has some history, I understand.
It does, quite a bit. Yeah. Every bit as much as you would think.
What was there something that struck you as, wow, this is the best thing I've ever done seeing? Besides the gelato.
Hey, the gelato was good.
This guy over here.
The gelato was good. I don't know. I think just walking around the Colosseum and just imagining when it was filled with people and chanting and yelling and Christians fighting each other and fighting bears and whatnot just kind of blew my mind. So, but then you guys came in town and we met you at the airport and we had to hop on a shuttle and get to the boat right away.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, then we got on the Odyssey of the Seas.
You sure did.
And lovely boat. Really, really nice. It was Jane's first cruise and my first week-long cruise. So I was a little nervous, like, okay, is Jane going to be okay with the cruise? Is she going to like it? And she did. She loved it. So it turned out to be great. And I don't know how long you want me to blather on, because then we had like multiple stops on the cruise.
Yeah, tell people where we stopped.
So first stop was Santorini, which is a gorgeous Greek island. And if you've seen the iconic pictures of the blue domed churches, that's probably Santorini that you saw. Mm-hmm. So we walked all over there, went on a selfie tour where they took us to all of the most iconic, iconically photographed places. And then we ended up seeing you guys and having a little dinner. It was beautiful. Like, it was one of those places. I was glad I got a day, but I think I want to go back. I think I want to go back and stay there for a little while.
The Santorini was is amazing to me because it's up on basically a mountain.
Yeah.
It's created by 400 years ago a volcano.
Huge volcano.
Yeah.
Yeah, the equivalent of 40 atomic bombs, they told us.
And then from there it made the basically the lagoon around it, if yeah. that's the right thing to say.
Caldera, I think
yeah,
they call it.
But it's attached to the sea.
Yeah. Yeah.
And man, it was hot.
Oh,
and you had to walk everywhere.
Yeah.
And I guess the musical Mamma Mia is supposed to be there.
I think so.
The island.
Yeah.
So if you ever saw the movie, you kind of get it. I don't even know if they were filmed there, but.
Yeah, I don't know.
It is something to see.
It is. And you're walking, you know, Santorini is an old city mm-hmm. or village. Santorini's the island.
It's the island, yeah.
But the villages are very old. And my gosh, they're just such narrow cobblestone streets. And it's like being in a completely different world.
Yeah.
So gorgeous. So, yeah. And you went to a distillery tour.
Yeah,
there, right?
We drank some ouzo. Is that what it's called?
I think that's it. Yeah, I think that's the Greek drink. And you said it was good.
Yeah, it was.
You loved it and yeah. whatnot. Yeah. So, and then the next day we're at... Oh.
Yeah, what was fun also on the cruise was that we went through the...
Oh, yeah.
The area between Sicily and Italy.
Mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
And we... It's like, I think we talked about this in our last podcast that we did, but we went up on the top to see both sides of it.
Yeah.
You were on the Sicily side watching it from your
yep.
from your suite.
Yeah.
And it was just so neat.
Oh, so cool. It was kind of like very reminiscent of State Line Road, you know? You can
yes.
stand there and, hey, there's Missouri. Hey, there's Kansas.
Yes.
Just, it's,
exactly.
It's every bit as cool as that.
Well, that's, I mean.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, they got the Chiefs now. The Kansas does.
I know. Damn it.
So, but that was, so in the crew, and, well, we can get back to the cruise, but. After Santorini, which mm-hmm. was so much fun.
Yes.
And I'm glad you hung around with us because you were going to go back on the bus.
Yeah, we were going to go back on the bus, and then we ended up staying and taking the cable car down,
yeah,
which was
fun.
A lot of fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was only €6. What's the big deal?
Right.
Yeah.
You could swing that. Then you went to another island.
Yeah, then we went to Mykonos.
Mykonos, yes.
Another Greek island. And on our tour, we went... First, this little village, not Mykonos Village is like the big main place there, but we went to another smaller village. It was fascinating. There were a bunch of restaurants and stores in this little town square, and they're all owned by these two priests in this monastery. So they told us it's like the richest monastery in all of Greece because these two priests own everything. I don't know how that works in the Orthodox Church, but it was fascinating. Oh, man, Gilly is scratching the heck out of my leg.
And they
leg.
Said something like there's more churches than houses there.
Yeah. Yeah, that was, there's like, I don't think, like 16,000 churches. It's crazy. Most of them are small family churches owned by the family, and they are only open typically they're only open on the day dedicated to the saint that that particular church is named after. So if it, for instance, was a St. Paul's church, it would be open on the feast of St. Paul
yeah.
or whatever. So that was fascinating, all of the churches there.
Yeah.
And we went to a little farm and then... And then they took us to this, to Mykonos. And my God, it was so very, very hot. Yeah. But we walked over there.
When we went to Mykonos, we went to Little Venice, which was the, I think we talked about this at our Gentleman's Breakfast podcast. Yeah. There's restaurants and things next to the waters, they call it Little Venice, but all these shops. And my wife loved just wandering around looking at the shops.
Yeah.
And I hated wandering around looking at the shops. But it was an interesting place to be.
It was beautiful.
I think it was so hot. Kind of buzzed me a little bit.
Well, and it was interesting to me because Mykonos is right on the water, whereas Santorini was, you know, way up high.
Yeah.
And unlike here, like that Little Venice area, it was a very thin walkway right on the water. No railings or anything. Mm-hmm. You wouldn't see that here. That'd be a liability bonanza.
Then the next day, another hot place was Turkey.
Turkey, yeah.
And you went everywhere on that one. You saw, we didn't. We just went shopping again.
Yeah, yeah.
But you went to some historical places.
We went to the city of Ephesus, which is being excavated right now.
It sure is.
And currently, 16% of Ephesus has been excavated and I don't want to say restored, but they're working to make sure that the ruins are maintained. And it was just fascinating. The ruins are about 3,000 years old there. And they were showing us little things like, hey, here's where chariots went through. And you could see like in the marble stones that made up the street where chariots had worn ruts in the stone. Yeah. They showed us a little stone on the street that told you where to find the ladies of the night when you came into town.
That's convenient.
Yeah. There was this gorgeous two-story marble library that was just unreal. And then they have, I think it's called the Great Theater. And I think they said it holds 25,000 people. And I stood in the Great Theater where...
So, I mean, Taylor Swift could just totally have three or four times that and you could do like five Trump rallies in there.
Yes, you could. Okay. All at the same time. Yeah. And it was cool because in the book of Ephesians it talks about Paul making an address to the crowd, and it was anti-paganism, pro-Christianity, but it took place in the Great Theater. Mm-hmm. So I was standing there going, wow, the Apostle Paul was standing here.
That's crazy.
Years ago. Then we left there and we went to the house of the Virgin Mary, where the Virgin Mary, according to Roman Catholic, she died there. According to Greek Orthodox Church, she lived the later years of her life there, but went back to Jerusalem before she died. And our tour guide was Muslim, and he told us that it is also a sacred spot for the Muslim religion, because Mary is mentioned 34 times in the Quran as the mother of Jesus. Mm. And so Muslims will make pilgrimages there too, because it's a holy spot for them.
I shouldn't say anything of this because I don't know the name of it, but there's also a theory that Mary was raised in a certain Jewish sect. Is that sect? S-E-C-T?
Yeah.
That's very mythical, I guess. Not mythical, but...
Mystical,
yes.
Oh, okay. I'm not familiar with this.
And that she was very influential in her son's philosophy of
things. Aha, okay. Well, it was cool. We went through the house, and it was, you know, you can tell there's an aura of sacredness there. Mm-hmm. You can tell it means a lot to the people going through, and you have to take off your hat, and you got to be quiet when you go through there. So
that's the water.
So they have a fountain that runs through there. Some people drink the water, but you're really not supposed to.
Yeah, because you get sick.
Because we'll get sick. But we did get some holy water from there and a little bit of the sacred dirt from Mary's house.
That's nice.
Yeah. So that was quite a day. Then we went down and had lunch and met you guys. And boy, it was like 100 degrees plus there that day.
So we... That was just the stops. There was two sea days. And the cruise was a lot of fun because if you've never been on a cruise, you go and you have yourself a nice dinner.
Yeah.
And we had some great servers.
We had like family dinner every night in the main dining room, which was fun.
Yeah, it was fun. Good food. Yeah, better than any cruise I've ever been on.
Very good food.
Then there's the pool, and then there's bars everywhere.
The piano bar was always a fun spot to end up at.
Yeah.
And then there was pizza that they served till 3 in the morning, which I got on far too many nights late into the night.
Well, because there's so much to do. There's Tony, the Las Vegas entertainer, the greatest entertainer of all time.
He was great.
But there's just so much. So every day I tried to take a little bit of a nap, so I stayed up. And I'm like, I'm going to go to bed early tonight.
Never did.
Because also, I loved getting up and going to breakfast.
Yeah.
And we only did that twice because no one else wanted to, number one. And number two, we had to get up to go.
Yeah, we had to get up early for the excursions. So that because we had 4 excursion days on a 7-day cruise. So that's quite a bit.
And I tried to get into the mood and the everything about it, because when it was dress up time, I had my seersucker suit on.
You looked good, buddy.
Look different and fun.
Yeah.
And drank a lot of John Collins.
You did.
Which was neat. I never really got drunk, though.
I never did either. Yeah. I mean, I drank more than a human should, probably, but I never got drunk.
There's a TikTok theory that they watered down.
They probably do.
Yeah.
Yeah. I would tend to agree with that.
Yeah.
And you know what? I'm okay with it, because I bought the drink package, so what the heck?
But these boats are gigantic.
Oh, yeah.
Just so much to do on there.
Mm-hmm.
And the things that aren't gigantic for me, a fat guy, but also a tall guy.
Yeah.
The showers are small.
They are.
And,
But
we're going to get into more. Because after Turkey, we went back the other way and went through the straits. Straight again. Is that a strait?
I think it is. I can't remember the name of it, but it's the Strait of something. Yeah.
And then our last excursion was to the Amalfi Coast.
Oh, boy. Yeah.
And back in Italy.
Gorgeous.
Ravello, and then to Amalfi itself. And Amalfi is a coastal city. There's coast near Naples, and they're also on a hill.
Yeah.
But just amazing views.
That may be the prettiest natural beauty I've ever seen.
Yeah.
It was really cool. Oh, I was talking about the coast.
Oh, I thought you were talking about my seersucker suit again.
That was cool too.
Yeah.
But it was cool because we stopped in Ravello, which is this little village high up in the mountains. Mm-hmm. And that was lovely. And then we go down to the coast and take a boat ride along Amalfi, and it was stunningly beautiful.
Then we went in through Amalfi shops and we had, it was something I dreamed about, and it came true. I had myself a margarita pizza.
You did.
The place where pizza was invented.
Oh, so good.
Named by Queen Margarita.
Really?
Basil.
Yeah.
Mozzarella, but it was buffalo.
Right.
Am I saying that right? Or what they call it?
I think it's just buffalo mozzarella.
Buffalo mozzarella.
Yeah.
And then just that the tomato sauce.
Yeah.
The 3 colors of the Italian flag. God, it was good.
It was good. And the buffalo mozzarella, I didn't know this. I'm sure our listeners do.
I didn't either, yeah.
This is how stupid I am. I always thought, it's mozzarella with buffalo chicken sauce on it.
Yeah.
No, it's mozzarella. The milk comes from the Italian buffalo that they make the mozzarella out of.
And I thought it was buffalo, like some type of language I didn't understand that was trying to describe it as big chunks of it.
Oh, yeah.
But I was wrong there, too.
Hey, that's okay. We learned.
Yeah.
We learned.
We ate.
Oh, God, we ate. We ate so much.
And then the other thing that the Naples region is known for is limoncello.
Mm-hmm.
This delicious liqueur.
Yeah.
So good. And then they had the lemon.
Aperitif? I don't know.
Lemon, like
sorbet type stuff.
Oh, my God. It was
so good.
So wonderful.
And they would put the lemon sorbet in an actual hollowed out lemon.
Yeah.
It was so much fun.
And so that was, and then back to Rome, and that was the end of our cruise, and seemed like the end of our fun.
But it wasn't.
But it wasn't. So let's take just a quick break and see what the texter has. He's been very patient. He says, and Brian's welcome to chime in here anytime, but I think he's listening. But Brian, you may have to pop on your microphone if the texter had any questions for you.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks. Smokey's a nerd,
uh-huh.
which I disagree with, texter. The next time, do you know who Jack Arnold is? I received an invite from Jack. I don't.
Yeah, that's weird.
I don't. I know who JoJo Arnold is.
Yeah. Yep.
In Rome, did you get pickpocketed?
So let me comment. Great question. We were told, watch out in Rome. Keep everything in your front pockets. They told us in Santorini, watch out. They told us in Mykonos, watch out. I did not get pickpocketed, and I never felt ill at ease. I never felt like, yeah.
Now, I was worried about that, and I got myself this wallet where you clipped your belt, and then you put it in your front.
Right.
In your front pants.
Yeah.
And I was worried. I was having dreams that I would lose my wife in the airport.
Oh, my gosh.
She is what they call scoochiliano and likes to wander around.
She's a wanderer.
Yeah. And sure enough, when we got to the airport, we found the guy who's supposed to transport us who couldn't speak speak our language. He just grabbed her bags and started walking away.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, I was worried about my friend Jane, making sure she was with us.
Yes.
And then you were with her, too.
Yeah, we were trying to find you guys.
It's like, is this all coming true? After that, I never felt worried about pickpockets or anything.
No, I never felt like I was being watched or any. Now, maybe I was. I don't know.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah, maybe they didn't know we were American.
Maybe we didn't stand out as tourists. Yeah.
Now, this is a question for Brian, I think, because I know it's true.
Oh, okay.
I heard you went to a wedding with Rod Stewart.
Yes.
Is that true?
Yes, we did. In Dubrovnik, people get married there at the churches all the time. That's the town where they filmed a lot of Game of Thrones.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
So it's very pretty. And all the time, there's a wedding party walking down the street, which is just a walkway. Mm-hmm. And everybody claps and, you know,
big hooray! Party.
Yeah, and then you do your thing. So we saw a wedding party go by, and then we go up those stairs, the Walk of Shame stairs.
Yeah.
From Game of Thrones, and there's a church up there, and there's a bunch of paparazzi out there. And lo and behold, it was not Ellen DeGeneres that some of the kids thought it was. It was Rod Stewart. His son got married to a Croatian girl at the...
In the
morning before the wedding, we went to some fort, tower, whatever, and there was people setting stuff up, and it was going to be closed at 2 that day because Rod Stewart had rented out that fortress for the wedding reception.
Wow.
I don't know what it cost to do that.
That's pretty cool. Yeah. Now, if it was the texter that it happened to, he'd probably say he had got drunk with him.
What?
I think he would have. Yeah.
Yeah. And he would have either done it or at the very least said he did it.
Yeah. He probably.
That's what I know about him.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Did you see any celebrities, Chris?
I don't think I saw any celebrities,
no.
Uh-uh. God. Yeah.
That's too bad. Tony. What was Tony's last name?
Was it Tony?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep. He was the greatest entertainer there ever has been.
Yeah.
Next question from the texter. Did you see the boner paintings in Pompeii? No.
I didn't see any boner paintings, and we didn't stop in Pompeii, but we did see Mount Vesuvius as we were driving up the Amalfi Coast.
Like most Americans, I have no geographic knowledge.
Right.
Let alone from Italy. I thought Naples was on the other side of the country.
I had no idea where it was, so you were a step ahead of me. We're just wrong.
And then Venice, that's where Venice is. So, and then I didn't realize that Pompeii and the volcano's right there. Naples.
Yeah, crazy.
So you got to see it. Great question from the texture coming up. When you're on State Line Road, do you swerve across the center line and say out loud, we are in Kansas, now we are in Missouri, now we're in Kansas, now we're in Missouri?
I did a video one time for a previous employer, and we were highlighting Kansas City, and I actually went to State Line Road, and I just hopped back and forth over the yellow lines going, now I'm in Kansas, now I'm in Missouri, now I'm in Kansas, now I'm in Missouri.
Yep. That's awesome.
People laughed and laughed.
Gosh, I'm trying a hard time controlling myself.
Yeah, it's funny.
The texture goes on that says 16% is very specific. Do you think they use such a specific number to give the illusion that they know what they were talking about?
Well, it is interesting. They mentioned 16% so many times, and he kept saying, you might think 16% isn't a lot, but I want you to hold off on that until you see it, and then at the end, you can tell me.
16% of what?
16% of the entire city has been unearthed at this point. Yeah.
Okay.
It could all be made
up. Was the Virgin Mary house haunted?
I don't think so, but it's impossible to say.
I'm of the mind that she wasn't a virgin at that point.
Oh, she probably wasn't.
I hope not.
Yeah. Yeah, she needs to live a little.
Steve Carell, he's asking if it was the Bering Strait or the Strait of Gibraltar.
I don't think it was either. Yeah.
Question, did you hang out with the mafia when you ate pizza?
It's hard to say. Maybe.
I don't think so, but we did after we went to Rome. We went to the place, the birthplace of the mafia.
Yeah, we sure did. Yeah, we had a nice 3 days in Sicily.
Now, we went on an airline from Rome to Palermo that I was calling ITA.
Right.
But it wasn't. It was IDEA?
ITA. Yeah.
And the customer service was so good.
Amazing.
And I am not the height of an average Italian person.
No.
I had a lot of trouble. You did too, right?
Those seats were the closest together I've ever been in an airplane on. And I've been on Spirit Airlines before.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that was a little rough, but only it was like a 45 minute flight.
Yeah, it was a short flight, thank heavens. So
we went to Palermo. We got the car, which took a little bit of time, but the people at Avis were great.
Yeah.
Everywhere, it seemed more. It's more in the U.S. than it is, I think, from what I saw other places. They're so short-staffed.
Yes.
And I found it interesting that Avis was short-staffed, and so was Delta, and probably United.
Mm-hmm.
The American companies were short-staffed. The other companies were fine.
Yep. Yep.
Which is just...
weird.
No, it's not weird. It shows what their corporate bottom line is about.
Well, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
But the people were nice. We got the biggest car available in Sicily, a T-Roc, and we needed help with our luggage.
We did. Thank heavens for Nancy's family helping us out.
At the airport, Nancy's cousin Francesca and her husband Pepe were there.
Yep.
And we popped a lot of our luggage in his car and then drove to where we were staying.
Yeah, what was that called? Hotel Almadirig is where we stayed.
Casa Malari? Kes?
Yeah.
What's the name of the city? Do you remember?
I don't remember, but you're on the right track.
I'll remember here in a second, probably. But man, what a beautiful little vacation.
Gorgeous.
It was about 30 miles, half an hour away from Palermo, north of the island.
Mm-hmm.
Just a little beach vacation community.
Yeah.
And nice hotel. I actually had air conditioning.
Yeah.
And
the best breakfast in the world.
Yeah, their breakfast was great. They had a great cappuccino espresso machine, you were quick to it too. I'm in Italy. I have espresso. I have cappuccino.
That's what you do. Yeah.
An Americano, what? That's stupid.
Please.
Brian's raising his hand, but I don't know. Yes, Brian, you have a question?
Yeah. I had breakfast one day in... I like crisp bacon, or as Jerry Lewis would say, very stiff bacon.
Thank you.
And it was not, it had the white, it looked like it was way underdone for me, but it was the most crisp, delicious bacon I've ever had.
Oh, wow.
It looked like it was going to be the bacon at a place where they had just shoved it out the door because they're...
Yeah, at the Hampton Inn or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, your rubbery bacon.
Did you find the same thing about service that I did in Croatia?
No. There are really no American companies there. Everything is Croatian. A couple of people talked about things are short-staffed, but part of that was because we went right before the summer season.
Okay.
Were
a couple of weeks before that.
Yeah.
But I felt like everything was staffed up. Everything was good.
Yeah. Even the U.S. companies?
There were really no U.S. companies.
Yeah, that's good. See, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So Castellammare di Gulfo.
Okay, yes.
Is the city we were in.
Yeah, Gulf of the castle.
Now, I had too many cappuccinos.
Oh, so good.
And just those croissants.
Yeah.
Either filled with pastry or filled with almost like a pudding type thing.
Or, yeah.
Yeah. Or just on its own with little brown, with a little powdered sugar. Mm-hmm. You went the other way. You went savory.
Well, I did have some of the pastries, and they were delicious. But yeah, I also had, you know, the meats and the cheeses. Kind of a charcuterie breakfast.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So damn good, wasn't it?
Charcuterie breakfast. Yeah.
Then we had a nice... Now, when you're in Sicily, you got to have seafood. So we had seafood first night, seafood pasta. I had swordfish pasta.
Yeah, I had mussels in my pasta. Yeah. Pasta.
Yeah, mostly the shells in
your
pasta.
Yeah, it's a lot of work.
But it was my wife's family came in from Poggio Reale, again, about 45 minutes away from where we were staying.
Yeah.
That was nice to see them.
That was great, yeah.
Then the next day was maybe my favorite day because we drove around Sicily, and I drove.
You did a hell of a job,
and you
too.
Were my navigator.
I was
less nervous. I knew where we were going.
Yeah.
And there was a couple things I wanted to show you. First was the Erice.
Yes.
Which is on top of a mountain, old city in Sicily.
So beautiful.
Our navigation was trying to get us to the bottom of the mountain where we could take the tram car up the mountain, but our navigation took us to the top. So I'm doing these back and forth driving, and Chris has let me know this is a hairpin curve. There's a hairpin curve.
It was hairpin after hairpin after hairpin.
Yeah.
Man. Yeah.
And we got there, and what'd you think of that little village?
It was absolutely stunningly beautiful. I loved it up there. And whatever their pastry is that they're known for is the best pastry I've ever had in my life, ever, hands down. And that includes a Mickey's honey bun. So.
That's safe. And you might not be aware, but this is another hairpin.
You know what? I wouldn't have known unless you gave me. I appreciate it.
You bet. Hairpin.
You like the hairpin bandit.
So anyway, you were telling me the hairpins.
That was not an exaggeration. Was that actual footage of us?
Actual footage.
It was just hairpin after hairpin.
And up and down the mountain.
Yeah. That was something. But that village up there was beautiful.
Oh yeah. So I dreamed about the pizza, but I also dreamed about having what is called a Genovese Erice.
Oh,
and
yeah.
It was so good. Pastry with cream in the middle of it.
Yeah, kind of a custardy something. Oh, powdered sugar on top.
With some espresso.
Unreal.
Unreal good.
Yeah.
I got one, and this happened a lot. I'm going to buy one, Nancy. And she's like, well, do you want to split it? No, I don't.
Yeah.
We got two.
Yeah.
Then you're like, I don't really want anything. You had a bite of it?
Yeah, I had a bite of Nancy's, and then Jane and I got two.
Yes.
So, yeah.
So good.
Oh, man. Yeah.
Then up there, it's a very touristy place, but it's not as populated as regular villages in Sicily. But you can see the view is just breathtaking.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely stunning, stupendous.
Yes. Then that same day, we drove another 45 minutes, maybe longer, to Sambuca, which my great grandfather is from.
Right.
And there is an outlook area at the top, another city, kind of on the mound, mountain this time, but
yeah, but up on a hill.
And I wanted you guys to see the outlook thing, and it was closed because they're redoing it.
Uh-huh.
Disappointed. But then some old man who is the only guy doing any
work.
Of the work there,
yes,
let us go up there and look at it.
Beautiful.
Then we met some friends, and we had to have, let me see what it's called here.
Oh yeah, and then Sambuca has their own pastry. It looks like a boob.
Yes. They call it the mini I'm sure I'm saying it wrong, but had an espresso with that, and it is supposed to be based on a boob.
It is, yeah, and it actually has burnt nipples on the top of every one. So
we giggled like children.
We did, we did, and it was very good. It wasn't as good as the Erice pastry to me.
No,
but
it wasn't.
It was very dense. Very dense,
yeah,
not as light.
Yeah, but you know, while in Sambuca.
Hey, amen, buddy.
Then we went to Poggio Reale and saw, very briefly, we saw a little bit of the ruins of it.
Mm-hmm.
And then saw the family farm.
Yes, that was cool.
Then Puerto Reale is a small place.
Mm-hmm.
And in 1968, they had an earthquake that destroyed the city. Then down the mountain, down the hill, a couple miles away, they just built a new city.
Just like, hey, we'll just build one here.
Yeah, and everyone got a new house.
Everybody got a free house that had been in the earthquake.
And
so
what's really kind of neat is that my wife's grandfather and father were like the first two to leave there to go to the U.S.
Yeah.
They were very well known. And the family's well known. They're all named the same first names.
Yes.
It's like,
yeah.
And so my wife's uncle had to show us around.
Yeah.
And we couldn't go 2 feet without someone running into him, knowing him.
Oh, yeah. Well, and then we ran into people that were Facebook friends with your wife.
Yeah,
and
they knew her.
They knew her. And, Nancy, my Facebook friend.
Yeah.
And, yeah, it was really cool.
It was fun. And then we went to a restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
It had so many appetizers and then pizza.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, it was insane.
And wine.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then at the end of it, Gino paid for all of it.
He did. What a guy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Really loved Gino. Very hospitable and great to have him to kind of bridge the language gap a mm-hmm. little bit. And, yeah.
And his cousin, Chichu, his daughter, Francesca, and son-in-law, Pepe, were all there.
Uh-huh.
Nice people, huh?
Could not be any more nice and inviting. My gosh, I started to cry a little bit at the airport. Chichu gave me a hug, and it was so tight. It was just, mm-hmm. it just touched me.
Yeah.
It was very sweet.
I was a little worried about dragging you and Jane along with their family and stuff, but they were so inviting to you.
Yeah.
And it was an experience. Then the last day we were there, what'd you do, Chris?
I laid on a beach. I had one relaxing day, and it was fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah, that beach was beautiful. It wasn't crowded. Just laid down on our beach chairs, would kind of fall asleep, go get in the water, come back out, fall asleep. It was awesome.
You were there just like a little bit longer than us, but we were there like time flew.
Yeah, we were there like 7 hours or something crazy like that.
Then we went to the more populated area of the village and had dinner. And then, of course, we had to have gelato.
And we had, like, big plates of pasta and gelato every night. And do you know, I lost 3.5 pounds on this trip.
Wow.
Even with all of the late-night eating and the boozing.
I knew you would have, because you guys really were more active. It scares me for me to see what I did.
We were very active, yeah.
Because,
but I'm feeling it now.
Because the next day, we traveled from Sicily back to Rome.
Yes.
And we had to go hit Rome.
Had to go, yeah, about a 45-minute cab ride to get to the city center of Rome. And we went to the, what's it called? The Piazza.
Piazza Nuvano?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. And again, we had to eat.
Had to eat. And
pasta.
I had another pizza there.
Where did we have that beautiful, was it, it must have been in Sicily, where that caprese salad?
Yes.
That was just out of this world great.
Yeah, so good.
And then there, I mean, just the drinks and the pasta.
Oh,
and
gelato.
I was trying to be very specific about where I went. In Greece, I tried to get the lamb.
Yeah.
In Sicily, I had the seafood. But in Rome, I had the northern Italian food.
You did.
Meatball and pasta.
Yeah, the cacio e pepe?
Yeah.
And you loved
it.
Oh,
my God, it was so good.
Yeah.
Walked around, saw some stuff. What?
I think it's Buca di Beppo.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Right, Fat Joe's Basement.
Yep.
And we didn't even mention the arancinis that we had multiple times, too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. There's like these risotto balls, rice balls that are deep fried, and they have different fillings in the middle.
We took as fast food.
Yeah.
One day.
Yeah. But I say it's more like good food fast.
Oh, that's awesome.
Good food quickly.
Yes.
So, and then that was it. Then we... we parted ways, Chris.
Yeah.
You went on United. But your flight was supposed to leave a couple hours before us. I say, you know, we're going to leave for the airport 3 hours before our flight. We're right next to the airport.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, my God. I'm so glad I did. What a pain to get in there.
Yeah, it was. The line was insane. We left a little later than we intended to. We wanted to, you know, leave Rome with a bang. And we got there, and the line for American and United was insane. Yeah. Then you guys came and got through the Delta line, and we're
quicker.
Still in line. And then finally, some woman comes back and she's like, are you United? Yes, you got to come up to the front of the line right now. Oh. And so they pulled us up to the front.
Thank goodness.
Then we were able to get on the plane. And I will say had a very uneventful, nice, for a 10-hour plane ride, it was great.
Did you have any trouble when you transferred from Chicago coming in customs?
Well, the only thing that happened, we thought we bought this big wedge of Parmigiano. We thought we had packed it in our check luggage, but it was actually in our carry-on. And we get to Chicago, and they pull my carry-on bag out. And this kid opens it up and pulls it out. And I thought, oh, we're going to lose this, whatever it was, $40 worth of. But he just put it back in and gave it to us, and we were on our way. So
we had trouble moving from terminal to terminal in Boston, but we made it. And the flight from Boston to Kansas City, no Wi-Fi, short seats.
Oh, God.
It was just like, oh, God.
Yeah, but we actually from Chicago to Kansas City, there was nobody else in our row. So I had a window. Jane had an aisle. We had a seat between, but yeah.
Then Maddie picked us up, and then we're back and worked on Friday.
Hey, and I'm about to pee my pants, so I'm going to run up and do that.
Well, no, you're going to wait a second, because we're going to go ahead and take a break, and then we'll be back with our news quiz and some of our regular stuff.
Yes.
We'll come back with more past week, next week with Chris and Paul. And I think the texter has a lot of questions for us, so I'm excited by that. But we'll be right back. Thanks for indulging us, folks, on all this stuff, but we had a lot of fun and want to let you know what we did. Past week, next week with Chris and Paul, starring Boogie. And introducing the texter.
Looking at the past 7 days, so you don't have to. You could join in on the experiment by calling or texting us at 913-735-0060.
We've been told that perfect mornings exist for the lucky few. That morning people own the waking hours. But the truth is, mornings belong to all of us. Your mornings are what you make of them. Takes is saying yes. Starbucks morning yes.
Look for Starbucks coffee in a grocery store near you, then sit back and enjoy the exceptional taste of Starbucks at home.
Hi, this is Chickless Goose from Counterclockwise KC. Listen to our program each and every Saturday and Sunday at 7 p.m. right here on KCTK Radio. Personality driven radio.
Hi guys, it's your old friend Paul from KCTK Radio, reminding you again to download the KCTK Radio app. You're listening and you're going, I don't need the app, but you do need the app. Here's why. It's free, okay? You already got Candy Crush, all kinds of jackleg apps on your phone.
It's free.
Yeah,
it's
just free. Get it for free. And then if you ever want to participate live sometime, you can put the notification on there. Also, you always can get the podcast on there as soon as they come out. So it's a fun thing to do. I'm asking you. I'm pleading with you. Please. You're going to have fun. I've noticed something about you. You need to relax a little bit. You know, you need to kind of chill out.
Get away from TikTok.
Yeah, get away from TikTok for a little bit and listen to the KCTK Radio app. It's free. It will get into your brain, and it will never leave you. So join us on the KCTK Radio app and have fun for once in your life. Do it. The KCTK podcast way.
I'm excited to tell you about Bronco Blue Cheese Dressing. Blue cheese dressing with a little kick. Bronco Blue is an artisan-made salad dressing dip created in small batches. It is like no other salad dressing you've ever had, and it's made right here in Kansas City. Bronco Blue Cheese Dressing is made by our favorite chef here in Kansas City, Stephanie Broncato. And Stephanie's been making this dressing since she was 10 years old. This is her secret recipe, and one of the only ones she won't share with you because it's that good. Bronco Blue is a small batch, artisan-made blue cheese dressing with only the finest ingredients, with no preservatives. It is like no other blue cheese dressing you've ever had. And you, folks, should try a jar today. You won't regret it. And you can get it by the pint or half pint, your choice. Bronco Blue Cheese Dressing, the official dressing of KCTK Radio. Now, I want you to go right now to www.broncobluecheesedressing.com. Again, it's www.broncobluecheesedressing.com to place your order today. Get Bronco Blue Cheese Dressing. Blue cheese dressing with a little kick. And tell them that Bo, the official Bronco of Bronco Blue Cheese Dressing, sent you.
And welcome back to Past Week Next Week with Chris and Paul, starring Boogie, introducing the Texter, and sometimes featuring Brian.
Yeah.
Brian, thanks for joining us today.
That's great to have you.
It's great to be here. Thank you for having me.
Let's see what the Texter has to say.
Okay.
I, in fact, did get drunk with Rod Stewart. Of course,
I figured. Yep.
Many of the listeners want to know if you guys were ever traveled outside the U.S. Well, this is the episode, if you rewind it, because
that you will find out.
That's all in the past. But also, what happened when we were gone, which I wasn't aware of this, Chris.
What's that?
That news happens even though we are gone.
But we're the news source for everyone.
I don't understand.
That don't make no sense.
Right. So let's give everyone an up-to-date on the news. How do you think you're going to do on the news quiz?
I don't know. It was nice to be unplugged from the news for the most part for a couple of weeks. So I don't know if I've got my news muscles back yet.
So I do like MSNBC.
Okay.
Okay. I think they're the only ones trying their best to tell the truth.
Yeah.
Lately. But on the cruise, if you go to the MSNBC channel, they have a lot of these. Like, they show the show, and then during commercial break, it'd be MSNBC promos, not real commercials.
Right.
Oh, my God, they love themselves. We're standing up for democracy.
Yeah.
Journalism is what we're all about. Just shut up.
Yeah. I'll say, did you watch, like, the BBC News Channel or Sky News at all?
Not really.
I did. And I'm like, oh, this is what news is like. Mm-hmm. Okay. It didn't feel like it had the slant that every American news outlet seems to have.
Now, in Rome, I did watch CNN International, which was a little more like that.
Yes. Yeah. A little more newsy.
Yeah. So let's see how we did. And this is the Slate News Quiz. Sometimes they let us play it. Sometimes they don't.
They're fickle.
And I'm assuming it's American news, but based on our experience, we could probably do.
Probably do European news as well.
Because we know so much stuff.
Yeah.
So let's start it. Which of the following has been described as a horrible city by Donald Trump, who then doubled down on the insults with false statements about its crime rate?
I don't know.
It's Milwaukee.
Okay.
Yeah,
and it happens to be the place where they're doing the Republican convention.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So,
yeah. Tell you what, that dude seems to be losing it even more of late.
He really is losing it, but it's so weird. At this point, does anyone give a shit about anything?
What do you mean?
Wisconsin is a swing state.
Yeah.
Is there going to be anyone that goes, hey, wait a minute. You're lying about my crime rate.
Mm-hmm.
And my city is not a horrible city. I don't think I'm going to vote for you anymore.
Oh, I don't. Yeah.
No.
No, I don't think that's going to make a difference.
Hey! Gilly's excited because Blue just came home, so bear with it. So we got that right.
Hey, good job.
The convention is, they scheduled it right after his sentencing hearing, so that's awesome.
Oh, cool.
So let's go to the next question. Which world leader traveled to North Korea on Wednesday for a summit with its reclusive leader, Kim Jong-un, in his first visit there in nearly 25 years?
Putin,
yeah.
Yeah, I saw that.
What?
Vladdy, yeah.
Vlad.
He's trying to build, his diplomacy and everything, and it's pretty pathetic.
Yeah, very sad.
And folks, we have a president right now with the Secretary of State who's doing that very well with us, and they're all freaked out.
Yeah,
about what's going to happen in November.
And I found it interesting. who knows if this is true, but I heard that they really wanted China to be part of it, but China's like, yeah, we got too much going on economically to be seen with you two guys right now.
Well, at this point, why would China and America are the two powers.
Right.
Why would they want to be with these basically two failed nations is what I call them. And I said that to you.
Wow. Okay.
I went there.
That's out there forever now.
Yeah. Take that. Now, Brian, did anyone mention American politics to you?
No.
Now, I in Sambuca, one guy asked us, well, I thought about Trump.
Yeah.
He seemed like a real rough character, I thought.
He did, yeah.
And he hates Trump, too.
Yeah, he does. It was
I think the world doesn't like Trump.
Mm-hmm.
But what are you going to do? Okay, two for two. The two environmental protests vandalized which landmark spraying with orange paint?
Stonehenge.
Stonehenge. I didn't hear about this at all.
Oh, you didn't?
No.
Yeah, they went up and put orange paint on it to protest fossil fuels. I don't understand. What does that do?
Stonehenge is a very big oil-producing country.
It's so stupid. I mean, I appreciate protests, but just think about what, I don't know.
It's also like protests is something we know about.
Yeah.
This isn't doing something for attention so you know about the issue.
Yeah.
You know about the issue. Have you seen the clip of someone yelling at, it was in Australia. Jerry Seinfeld is doing his act.
Yes.
And someone starts yelling about Free Palestine or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And he lays into them. It's pretty funny.
It was hilarious.
Yeah. And no matter where you're on that issue, you should watch him talk about it because, this is really going to do it.
Yeah.
This is really going to change things. And these protesters nowadays, I don't know what they did there. Maybe they saw us 1960s movies and thought we'll use the same tactics.
Maybe so. I don't get it. But I loved how Seinfeld handled that.
One of my favorite books, and when I was in politics, I would have people that work for me. I'd give them this book called Rules for Radicals.
Oh, yeah.
And it was written by, and I might remember his name right now. But
Chris?
No.
No.
It wasn't Chris. Shoot. You're thinking of the guy from MSNBC book. But this is a different one.
Okay.
But one tactic, for example, he was a community organizer, and he would do protest. There was a place in the 60s, a department store that would only let black people shop on one day of the week.
Oh, wow.
Okay? So everyone was like, well, we need to just not go there anymore. We'll show them.
Mm-hmm.
He goes, no. On that one day, they had tons and tons of people come in.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
And show how much money they made.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that was a tactic that, and so they opened up where you could shop there any day.
Yeah.
Okay. His other philosophy was, Saul Alinsky's his name.
Okay.
Okay. His other thing was that he believes that Gandhi would have used the machine gun if it would have worked.
Oh, wow.
So his whole thing is that you use the tactics that work.
Makes sense.
Right?
Yeah.
And that Stonehenge thing don't work.
No.
All right? And the stuff on the campus for Palestine don't work.
Yeah. Who's going to say, well, you know what? Now that they painted Stonehenge, I do think we should stop using fossil fuel.
Right.
What? No.
Right. And we got to get creative with things. And unfortunately, I think the way you stop... Well, I don't know. I don't know anymore with the media, because I think people who are generally against they call it free Palestine. They use that.
Yeah.
Is they don't want the suffering in Palestine. They've seen it.
Yeah.
But most people haven't.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
And I think that would be the tactic, let more people see what's going on.
Yeah.
So anyway, okay. Next question. We've been three for three. Governor Wes Moore of Maryland announced plans to pardon as many as 175,000 people for offenses related to which crime?
It doesn't have to be marijuana.
It is marijuana. That's right. Yeah. Bill Maher on his show says that he wants Wes Moore to run for president.
Well, he loves the marijuana.
But that is very interesting. And I think a wave of the future.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Do you think the president should say he would do this?
I think it's time for it to be federally mm-hmm. legal. Mm-hmm. I mean, we're just piecemealing here. Yeah, I think it's time then expunge the records of folks.
I don't know. Our whole justice system needs to be looked at, but really all of our systems need to be looked at.
Yeah, amen.
Someone gets a minor offense in marijuana, then they're in jail, and then that's basically school to become a real criminal, and then it's just the spiral is there. Hard to get a job afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're doing good so far.
Yeah.
Question 5. Which was the nickname of baseball great Willie Mays, who died this week at 93?
Oh, man. Oh, you got it.
Oh, yeah. He was the Say Hey Kid.
The Say Hey Kid.
Brian, you were a big baseball before you went to soccer, right?
Football.
Yeah.
Not as good as Caller 6, right? He's a baseball nut.
Not as much. I used to be. And then it just kind of fell away. Yeah.
But there's an argument that could be made that Willie Mays is the greatest baseball player ever played.
Mm-hmm. That's what I think Babe Ruth still has the biggest WAR, the wins against replacement
mm-hmm.
number. But I think people consider Willie Mays the best.
Wow.
Well,
what about Willie Mays Hayes? I always thought he was pretty good.
Yeah, he was.
And Willie Mays Akins.
Yeah.
That's awesome. All these. I wish my name was Willie Mays something.
Yeah.
Willie Mays Lavoda, so I could play baseball. Wow. For a week that we weren't here.
Yeah, we did pretty good.
We got all of them right and even added a little bit of our own 2 cents. Let's see what this texture has to say. I'm sure it's going to be insightful.
I bet it's good
stuff. What about Hunter Biden? Any thoughts on that, Chris?
I have some thoughts on that. He was found guilty, and I didn't hear his father come out and call it a witch hunt or lawfare or anything along those lines. I didn't hear Hunter Biden call it that either.
Yeah.
I think that's the way to handle this kind of stuff.
I really think that on the things that happened to Trump in New York, where he's found guilty. If he wasn't Trump, I don't think he would be prosecuted for that.
Mm-hmm.
But that's hard to say because it was for the election. You
right.
know what I mean?
Right.
It basically is an election suppression.
Yeah.
Fraud.
It was a fraud for the election
yes.
against our right. democracy. I also don't think Hunter Biden would have been charged with this if his name wasn't Biden.
Yeah, I think you are
so
correct.
So when people say that, I'm like, yeah. And there's too much politics in the judiciary nowadays, I think.
Yeah, especially in the Supreme Court, yeah. it seems.
And then, Trump's charges should have been federal. Yeah, but they weren't because underreported folks, the attorney general during the Trump administration suppressed it.
Yeah, right.
And the prosecutor in New York worked in that office and knew it and then went there and said, this is bullshit.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Anyway, yeah, you're right about that. The thing is about our system is that if it does not discriminate against felons, it does not.
No,
yeah.
not even
Good
a
point.
Little bit.
Good point, Texter. No. The Texter, again, wraps it up in a nice package. Mm-hmm.
Puts a bow on it, cherry on top.
And then we get to move on. Hey, Chris.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, there will be next week's.
Oh, yeah.
Sucks
because we're leaving our vacation behind us.
Yeah. And we get you ready with a segment called Headlines and Predictions. And it's bad because for the last couple of weeks, you haven't had that. Even our special episodes, we haven't had that. So I want you all to be ready for just a really hilarious Headlines and Predictions to get you ready for the next week.
Oh, boy, you really set the bar high.
I sure did.
A reminder for folks, since we've been out of town a minute, this is where we take actual news stories and we write our own punchlines mm-hmm. to them. And let me just say, I wrote these on Friday morning after I'd gotten home late on Thursday, and I've not come back to them. So
okay.
I don't know how these are going to go.
Fair enough.
But we'll start out with this, guys. Dangerously hot temperatures are scorching the U.S., the result of a record-breaking heat wave that's shifting to New York. More than 100 million Americans are under heat advisories, watches, and warnings through the Northeast and Southwest. Widespread upper 90s and even triple digits will be possible around Washington, D.C. If the nation's capital reaches the 100-degree mark, it will be the first time since August 2016. Scientists have warned that heat waves will become more frequent and severe as the climate crisis intensifies, all of which makes clear we need to seriously consider adding the Ten Commandments to every weather forecast. Paul?
Thanks, Chris.
Sure.
And by the way, this heat wave, that was one of the things I noticed in the news overseas. It's everywhere.
Yeah. Yeah, it is everywhere.
Worldwide. Thanks, Chris. The Supreme Court is turning towards the final frenzy week of its term, ready potential blockbuster decisions on abortion, guns, and former President Donald Trump's claim of absolute immunity. Trump's team says there is a distinction between official acts by Trump pursuant to his presidential duties and his private conduct. In other closely watched cases, the judges will decide what happens when pregnant women show up to the hospital with medical emergencies in states that have strict abortion bans. The Supreme Court's decisions are expected by the end of the month, right after all the bribes and free vacations are due to the justices.
God dang.
Yeah. Chris?
It's true. Hey, thanks, Paul. Israel's top military spokesman has said Hamas cannot be destroyed, casting doubt about whether the government's war aim of defeating the militant group can be achieved. The comments drew a sharp rebuke from Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu and showed the deepening rift between the Israeli government and its military. In fact, some experts believe the rift is so bad that Bibi may drop a new diss track in the next few hours. Paul?
Thanks, Chris.
Sure.
TikTok ramped up its attacks on Biden administration over a law that could ban the popular app from the United States, arguing in a court filing that U.S. TikTok users could be forced to live on an island of content disconnected from the rest of the world that the platform is forced to find a new owner. Under what is now U.S. law, TikTok is forced to find a new owner by January 2025 or be banned by the U.S. entirely. TikTok has insisted it is not possible for its Chinese parent ByteDance to diverge from the app since it would be unable to dumb down Americans, the point of this and all other social media. Chris?
Again, I don't know if it's jokes or just truth you're spitting over there. Holy cow.
You'll like the next one then.
Oh, good. Experts are now saying there's a chance that your four-year-old toilet paper could be expired, if you still have it on hand, that is. According to a new report, most toilet paper brands do list an expiration date. A home improvement blog found that rolls of TP last more than their expected shelf life of 3 years when they're stored in a cool, dry place. However, moisture, like that of a damp basement, oily discharge, or watery diarrhea, can cause it to degrade. Paul?
That's not news. I know that.
I know. I don't know.
And finally, in 2018, a city government planted 9 palm trees near Halifax Harbor, choosing varieties grown in most northern areas of Japan and China. But the maritime winters provided too much for these trees. 5 died by 2022, despite efforts to protect them, including insulating the trunks and reporting leaves inside during the cold months. 2 trees died on the experiment, and the last 2 trees failed to bloom this spring. But there is good news for the town. Due to climate change, all tropical weather planets will be quiet at home in Canada in as little as a few years.
Ah, again, just truth.
Yeah.
Wow, you are a soothsayer.
Wow, we did it.
Yeah.
And you know who did it with us?
Brian?
But also the texter.
Right, both. Yeah. This is crazy.
He says, now let me set the scene. It's 2 in the afternoon. 34 degrees, Queens Island, hot summer heat. I've been sweating buckets up and down the street. This is like a story. I love it.
Yeah.
It was there when I spotted the...
Bloke?
Bloke. Bloke? How come it's the...
Bloke.
Bloke, yeah. First. There's something that is covering it. The bloke searched atop its milk crate throne. He eyed me up as I approached, and then he said, I am on Smoko. So leave me alone.
I don't know what that means, but it sounds like a surreal scene that has been set.
Yeah.
Did that really happen, Texter?
I don't know. Texter, tell us if that really happened. Brian, do you know anything about this?
I do know that song. Oh. Texter is doing a song.
What song is it?
And it's called Smoko.
Oh, okay.
I'm not familiar with Smoko.
Huh.
Yeah.
Again.
You should
We should. Well, you should. You should play it one day.
Okay, I'll check it out again. Yeah. To the point of what we've been talking about, the textures always wraps it up.
Yep.
And 34 degrees is like Celsius.
So right.
Like
so that's 80. Very hot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What was the Celsius when we were over there in Europe, like in Sicily?
29.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right around there.
So Chris, and Brian and Texter, what do you guys got going on for the next week?
Man, well, it's back to work. It's been two full weeks off of work. And so, you know, going to see what's happening there and kind of get back to real life, which is always a little bit hard after vacation. But I'd rather it be hard than not hard.
Yeah, I mean,
if you know what I mean.
Yeah, thank you.
Because if it wasn't hard, that means that maybe the trip wasn't that good. But it was so good, mm-hmm. You know. But it will be nice to feel productive again and get back to life, and then also just like feel normal in sleep and all that.
We went to a lovely wedding last night.
Ooh.
Our friend Ella Skaggs married.
Nice.
Sydney Wilson.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, Trent is a good friend and he's lovely. But we were talking to people and friends that knew that we were on vacation, and we go, oh, yeah, we're so tired. And then I finally said, wait, let me stop complaining about this great vacation I just went on.
Yeah.
But yeah. It is exhausting. And just so everyone knows, the vacation we went on was a dream vacation that you think, when I'm rich enough, I'm going to go on something like that.
Yeah.
Well, that never happened.
No, the rich part never did.
And it went anyway.
Yes.
So.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's a really good blessing because, quite frankly, I was going to say 15 years, maybe 5 years, I couldn't do it.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So it was a perfect time.
It was good. Yeah. Now's the time to do it.
Can't afford it at all.
No.
No. Yeah. But it was a great, and I'm really blessed that you and Jane were able to come.
Thank you so much for inviting us. It truly was the trip of a lifetime.
Yes. And you know what could be a better trip?
What's that?
Croatia 2025.
Oh.
And I'm sure Brian he doesn't want to say anything now, but I'm sure like a penciled mm-hmm. invitation.
That's nice.
In the language
will yeah.
be sent to
yeah.
us.
Oh, I can't wait.
Yeah.
That's going to be fun.
Truly.
Great.
Truly.
And Brian, your trip too. I mean, as you have really talented and ambitious kids, who knows what their life's going to bring? Will you be able to even get them all back together again? You know?
I don't think we even tried, you know, because schedules, it just worked at this time, and it was amazing.
That's awesome. You'll have the memories forever.
Yeah, so that's good. But it's hard to get back. So nothing really fun planned for you for the next
time? I don't think so, man. It's just getting back in the swing of things, getting my sleep schedule right, and going back to work, you know?
What about you, Brian? You start a new job. You got a new truck. Everything's going good for Brian.
Got a family reunion coming up next weekend.
Well, that sounds fun.
Yeah.
Will caller 6 be there?
Oh, yeah. I think he's going.
Haven't seen him in a while. I need him.
Yeah.
He was I was invited to have slaps of barbecue with him yesterday.
Oh,
I couldn't
make it. Oh, nice. Here's something fun I forgot. So during the trip, we had Father's Day.
Yes.
And we had Molly's Gotcha Day.
Okay.
And so Tuesday night, Molly and I are going to go out and do a double celebration
together
and celebrate Father's Day and Gotcha Day.
Did you do a big Father's Day, Brian?
Yeah. The kids did a good job for me last week.
Yeah.
Nice.
Steak for me and some clothing.
Oh, that sounds fun.
My daughters were amazing because one called me. And then mm-hmm. picked me up from the airport. And the other one did not call me, didn't care, but she took care of Gilly when I was gone.
Well, there you go. I mean, you can't be too upset about that.
Yeah, that's the most important thing.
Yeah.
So, you know, if you were to ask me what I got going on.
Yeah,
I'm
curious.
I would respond by saying.
Yeah.
It's going to be a long summer.
It is.
Long, sad summer. I guess I'll just have to use memories for fun.
Hey, you've used memories for lots of things before.
Yeah. Oh, I'll be darned. Do we have some texts coming
in? Oh, we missed.
Let's see what we got, guys. I apologize for not watching this. Okay. From Boogie.
Yeah.
What is the worst? That's the worst What's Up Suckas I've ever heard in the history of What's Up Suckas. Show me the money.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Those are old, I think. Oh, here's today's. Speaking of race, how many black people are in Croatia? Great question. Brian?
There was a couple.
Okay.
There's a couple, and there was actually a few Pacific Rim people there, too.
You know what? Oh, wow. Did you have this feeling like I did in Sicily? Why did my ancestors leave this place?
Yeah, it was just stunningly beautiful.
And I'm not bringing it up just because there wasn't very many black people there. Okay, that wasn't the reason.
No.
But
I know why.
Why?
Same reason they left Croatia.
Mm-hmm. Why?
It's because they were dirt poor.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Dirt poor and no opportunities.
Yep.
And treated like slaves.
Yeah.
Speaking of Rome, how many black people were in Rome? Do you want to answer that, Chris? You want me to?
I will say... I actually saw more black people in Rome than I thought I would see.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say it was a significant amount of the population that I saw there, but I saw more than I thought I would. Mm-hmm. I don't know what I expected, but yeah.
And by saying that, you mean people that live there, that are locals.
Yeah, yes. it looked as if. Yeah.
Not tourists.
Right.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. Then he adds that JoJo would have played in the Colosseum.
Isn't Heck yeah, true? He would have.
You've been asked.
He would have tore it up, too.
And then at about half an hour ago, we got from Jack, who's all up in your face. Glad you both are back safe.
Well, that's nice.
But all three of us are back safe.
Yeah. So I guess he missed one of us.
And Boogie isn't back.
No.
So he's messed up there. But that's the show, guys. We like to stop the show.
Yeah, we do. And you like it even better when we do.
And I'll go ahead and play this one. But go ahead, Chris.
Yeah. Hey, everybody. Thanks for listening to Past Week Next Week with Chris and Paul. Featuring Boogie. Starring Boogie, introducing the texter, and sometimes featuring Brian.
Yeah.
Since you love the program, please rate and review the podcast on your favorite podcast distributor. We'd love to hear from you, and you can contact us at 913-735-0060. Also, join the Past Week Next Week Facebook page. On behalf of Paul, I'm Chris saying goodbye.
And on behalf of Chris, I'd like to play a song.
I grew up always the bigger side as a kid. I was always slightly...
I'm not sure why.
That's weird. A commercial for a weight loss drug. You never see that.
Talk about algorithms.
Oh, boy. Yeah. Good. Yeah. Good. Good call on this one.
So this is Soul to Soul, Back to Life. And that's basically what we're going to go through the next week.
Well, you know what? At least we have a good song to help us get there.
Yeah.
I used to love this song. It's got a sweet beat. You know that.
There's a whole bunch of bands like Soul to Soul that were in the 90s pop R&B.
Yeah, kind of poppy, hip-hoppy. Yeah.
They never really stayed around, did they?
No. Not a ton of them. Yeah. Who was your favorite?
The Groove is in the Heart, people.
Okay. Yeah. I really liked De La Soul.
Okay.
Back in the day. The Soul.
Are they still around?
I think they may still be around. But yeah, there were so many. Salt and Pepa is still around, right?
Mm-hmm. Wonder why the nostalgia for them hasn't hit yet.
Yeah, I don't know. It will, for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is just good, man. It's got a sweet beat. You can dance to it, you know. However do you need me? There's something about a pop song that has a violin, too, that I'm a big fan of. The strings are haunting. You know what I mean?
Haunting for sure.
Yeah. Whoa. What I wouldn't give to be able to shake my hair like that.
You ain't got no hair.
I know. That's what I'm saying. It's crazy. It's growing out, too. I feel shaggy.
You better get yourself together.
Yeah. Speaking of Shaggy, is he still around?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's getting his master's degree, graduated.
No way.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I did not know that.
He's going to be a physical therapist.
No way.
Yeah.
Huh. I'll be darned.
I think he should be an actor.
Yeah.
Because he played the role of Chris Whiting one time.
Shaggy. What year was this? Huh.
15 years ago? No.
That's got to be older than that, right?
I want them to sing Back to Life and then we can stop the show.
Okay, sounds good.
If you want more information about this content, then you have some real weirdness going on. You can always check out KCTK Radio on Facebook. Listen to live programs at kctkradio.com. Yes, and that is on the World Wide Web. Thank you.